So I think asset digitization has massive benefits for enterprise businesses and for their clients and their end customers. And the way to look at this is forget about some of the technology that's held you back in the past and think about, you know, the platforms that we have now, the hybrid platform, the secure platforms, the interoperable, the ease of use, where you can in essence digitize any asset. And I do mean any asset, you know, physical assets, you know, financial assets, people assets, time, expertise, all of those you can use single platform to digitize those. What you do with them next is really down to your business model, and it gives you a whole new world to think about how to monetize, how to make your customers happy, and how to grow your businesses. So if we take the what I would call the ultimate digital asset, which is a central bank digital currency, the last 2 or 3 years, I'd say every bank in the world is talking about it. And all the institutions, you know, the financial institutions are working on it, and academia is researching it. Because it's not an easy process. It seems very simple, but it's not. And I think there's a couple of reasons why everybody's looking at this at the moment. The first one is just, from the financial crisis, we learned a lot back, you know, 10 years ago, so now a little bit further, but we learned a lot about how we manage our financial systems, and all governments want to make it more efficient and faster. So that's led us down a digitization process, a transformation process, and a lot of the big banks in G7 countries, like the, you know, the really big countries, have started to automate things a little bit more, make payments faster, make them clearer, etc. The next natural step of that, or in a few steps, is going to be a central bank currency, where it's a digital currency held, you know, safely, securely, and transacted. I think where the world is at the moment, you've got sort of two different, say, levels of CBDC work. The first one is the big banks, the G7 banks. So they're working very much on research, lots of research, lots of thought leadership, lots of, you know, academic and theory testing. So they're a little bit further back in the process of, if this is the goal of where we launch, they're still at this first part. But some are moving fast, some are moving slow as ever. There's then everyone else, and obviously that's, you know, hundreds of countries, where they're all doing different things, keeping an eye on what the G7 type countries are doing, but they're trialing it in different ways. And some of that is just research, some of that is actually launching types of currencies. And so where we've worked at Symbol Platform is a really good solution for Bank of Lithuania. So the Bank of Lithuania has launched in 2020 the LB coin, which is in essence the first manifestation of a central bank currency in the world, whereby people in Lithuania, or anywhere actually, you can still use it, but for the people of Lithuania, they could use this LB coin to transact. Now, it's a token, it's an asset, and it's based on our platform, but the manifestation of it is also a silver sort of collectible coin. So it's bridging the real world and the digital world. And the reason they've done that is we need to understand, for a CBDC, how people interact with it. Because we're used to having pounds and coins and notes. So it's a really interesting test and trial they've done to actually see what people, how they interact, what they do. And that also for Lithuania has allowed them to work with the EU and the European Central Bank on what's next, because they're doing a lot of academia. Lithuania has a lot of real research now. So I think for CBDCs and for central banks to make a success of this, they have to use a hybrid blockchain. Hybrid blockchain is the combination of public and private. A CBDC inherently is public and private. It's the citizens of your country using what is a very secure private, you know, the monetary system, the financial system. So the great thing with Symbol Platform, you get those together automatically built in. So there's no extra work, there's no moving the transactions and then having issues and risks around that. The private side stays within your firewall. The public side, where the citizens will use your currency, that works together. So it's really important that the security side of things are as high as possible, because this is your central currency, your central bank. But you also have to, it has to interact with the people, otherwise there's no point. So again, all of this is about efficiency and speed, but with full security and full transparency. And that's what hybrid blockchain gives you. And that's why, you know, Symbol Platform is leading the way with this.